Yes, they were, dear. We come before you right now to the throne of grace, Lord. Lord, we bow down before you, God. God, we come dragging all our stuff right to you, Lord. Lord, we ask that you come in and sit and sup with us. We open the doors of our hearts this morning, Lord. As that you come in and you make us and recreate us. Take the pieces that the world has broken apart and put them back together again, God. We're open for that today, Lord. Lord, we give you dominion and the space in our lives to do what you will with us, to work your way, to do it your way, God. God, we ask right now in the mighty name of Jesus that you continue to lead us down a path of righteousness. Lord, we thank you for everything you do and every single thing that you are. Lord, we thank you for another day to worship. We thank you for another day to praise. We thank you for another day of working out. Lord, we thank you that you continue to work with us, that you continue to build us in and throughout our lives, Lord. We just want to say thank you. We thank you for the word that's going to come about. We thank you for the speaker of the hour. We thank you for the blessed man that you have allowed us to be blessed with in this house as our leader. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for everything that you continue to do in this church, through our lives, through our experiences. We thank you, Lord, that you continue to allow us to experience you. We thank you, God. We ask that there's protection and traveling grace for those who are still on the way. We thank you that they are taken care of and that you've brought them through the highways and the byways to service, God. We thank you ahead of time. We thank you for your protective angels that are covering us in and throughout the time that we need, Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you for your grace and your mercy that you give us daily. Lord, we thank you. Lord, again, we ask that you come in and saturate this place on this day at this hour to do that thing that you want to do. Lord, forgive us for anything that we do that's not like you, God. Continue to make us more like you, God. Continue to make us more like you. And we say thank you for it. We say thank you for all the times you kept us. If you don't do nothing else, we say thank you for what you've already done. God, and we give you praise and glory in Jesus' mighty name. And let us say amen.
Amen.
We're going to go into praise and worship.
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. How's everybody doing this morning?
Praise
Is God not a good God? And worthy to be praised? Do me a favor, just give him a hand of praise. The saints used to say, they said they were going to go down the boulevard today. Is that all right? Tell somebody, glory, glory, hallelujah.
Glory, glory.
Y'all know it.
Hallelujah. Since I laid my burdens down.
Y'all sound like a young church. I know y'all know it.
Glory, glory.
Come on, say, since I made.
Since I made my burdens down.
Come on, say, glory, glory, glory. Come on, put your hands on. Majesty, whimsical God, it might be like that for you, but every now and again, sir, I don't. Sometimes you, it's hard to lay them down. But tell somebody, I've learned how to lay them down. I've learned how to lay them down.
I've learned.
Right. Do me a favor, just for this next moment. Would you do me a favor, just lift your hands to the Lord and just put in the Spirit who He's been to you. You've been my friend. You've been my father. You've been my healer. You've been my joy. You've been my strength. You've been my redeemer. You've been my joy. You've been my songs and sorrow. You have been everything I've needed. You've been. Come on, fill the place. Fill the place. Fill the place with your worship.
Our Father, you are home. We give you glory and we bless.
That's the whole song.
Our Father, you are home. We give you glory and we bless.
Come on, let's just testify to him.
Our Father.
Thank you, son.
You are home.
Yeah. Yeah. Come on, come on, lift that refrain in your spirit. We're gonna be a big mass choir to him today.
Our Father, our Father, yes, you are holy. We determined to give you glory, and we bless your name. Our Father,
can we take it up?
Your name, our Father. Hallelujah. You are holy. Thank you. We give you glory and we bless your name, our Father.
Say, you are my healer.
You're my healer.
Yes, sir.
We give you glory and we bless.
Yeah.
Your name, our Father, you're my healer, you're my healer.
Come on, call out what he's been.
We give you glory and we bless.
Yes, sir.
Your name, our Father, my provider, my provider.
Hey.
We give you glory.
Yes, sir.
And we bless.
Good God.
Hallelujah.
His truthful name, hallelujah, it's the name that brings down
represent. It's the name that brings down rumors. It's the name that gives rejuvenation. It's the name this morning. Come on, somebody bless him for the name. Come on, somebody bless him for the name this morning. Somebody bless him for the name this morning. Somebody bless him for the power in his name. Hallelujah. Bless him for the power in his name this morning. Bless him for the wonders in his name this morning. And we bless your name. Come on, let's do it, church. And we bless your name. And we bless your name. Your style might not be my style, but together we bless your name. Hallelujah. I might wave my hands a little bit. I might fall out a lot. But tell somebody, we bless his name together. We bless his name together, for it is he that has made us. Yes, sir. And not we ourselves. We are the sheep of his pasture, Elder Jerome. Tell somebody, I'm so glad that we get to do it together. I'm so glad that we get to love on him together. I'm so glad that we get to bless him together. Do me a favor. Let's give him one more round of truth in the room. Come on, make it a jovial sound. You don't got to scream. You don't got to shout. But there is a commandment that I will bless the Lord. Hallelujah. At all, tell somebody, at all times. Good times, up times, downtrodden times. Tell somebody, it's a commandment. It's a commandment. It's a commandment. And we bless his name. Hallelujah. We as a people, as we bless his name, we as a people harness to who he is. We as a people produce a praise in the atmosphere that he is pleased with. Come on. And we bless his name. Let's give him one more round, church. And we bless his name. And we bless his name. And we bless his name. We bless his name. Hallelujah. For his great goodness, for his wonderful works. And we bless his name. He made us. He created us for it. Hallelujah. He postured us for it. Hallelujah. Glory means the weight of. Hallelujah. I'm so glad that he gets the weight out of us. He gets all of those things. Every time I mention his name, it's weight in the room. Every time I mention his name, depression got to move a little bit. Every time I mention his name, hallelujah, anxiety has to get out the way. Because when we bless him, we put a weight on our situations. We put a weight on our opposition. We put a weight, hallelujah, on our adversity. Tell somebody, and we bless his name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory, and we bless your name. I imagine when my brother was talking, I imagine God coming in the room and pushing everything that's not like him out of the room. So imagine if you gave God the space to settle down in your spirit, he would begin to push those things out you don't need. You know what I mean? I just imagine God on a takeover today. I want God to take over. We give you glory and we bless your name. Hallelujah. 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 Ooh. And we bless your name. We give you glory and we bless your name. Because you are Jehovah Jireh. Because you are Jehovah Nisi. I'm just saying, I don't know what God's been to you, but he's been a whole lot of things to me. My provider, my healer, my friend, my bridge. When there was trouble, he was my bridge. When everything didn't look right, he said, I'm going to bring you your bridge. I'm going to be your bridge to get you from over there to over here. My provider, my everything. When I think of the goodness of Jesus, my soul keeps me anchored to God. Try not to go out of my soul. My soul.
My soul.
Who is bigger than me? My soul, my innermost parts, my soul. Ooh. Ooh. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. My soul, my God. I may not always do the right things or say the right things, but I command my soul to worship and to bless God. My soul, okay, God, we're going to do this responsively. My soul. We are reading from Psalms 139, 14 through 18, and Psalms 18, 14 through 24. It is in the New King James Version. I will read the unbolded, you will read the bolded, and then together we will read the last bold line. Amen? I will praise you. And why? I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are your works that my soul knows very well. My soul knows them. Yes, your turn.
My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in secret. And skillfully wrought in the lowest parts of the earth.
Wow. When I was at my lowest, God still saw me. I'm just saying. Your eyes saw my substance being yet unformed. And in your book, they all were written. The days fashioned me for me when I as yet there were none of them.
How precious also are your thoughts to me, oh God, how great is the sum of them.
If I should count them, there would be more in number than in sand. When I awake, I am still with you.
The Lord is my strength and song, and he has become my salvation.
The voice of rejoicing and salvation is in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly.
The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly.
I shall not die.
That's it.
I'm sorry, I kind of like that part. I shall not die. And declare the works of the Lord.
The Lord has made me severe, but he has not given me over to death.
That means he got us together, but he didn't give us over to where we could have been. Open to me the gates of righteousness. I will go through them.
And I will
praise the Lord.
What is going on?
This is the gate of the Lord, through which the righteous shall enter.
I will praise you, for you have answered me, and have become my salvation.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone.
This was the Lord's doing. And guess what? And it is marvelous in our eyes. Let's read together. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. May the affairs of your life be met with undeniable victory. As the Lord is messing with the theology of those who oppose you, they will ask the question, who did it? And we shall say, hallelujah. We will say God did it. Amen. We welcome you. We welcome you to, oh, the church motto. I'm sorry, Pastor. We gonna go back. We gonna go back. Can we just say the church motto together, please? This is the Lord's church.
And Jesus is Lord.
This is the church that's being established by his word. This is the church that love is building. The gates of hell shall not prevail. This is the Lord's church. And Jesus is Lord. Amen. I feel welcome. Do you? Welcome to all the people who are online. Welcome to Empowering Word Ministries, where we're the church that love is building. Love covers. Love covers. Love covers. That means if my slip is showing, Pastor Nanny, you come down and you tuck my dress down without telling everybody in the room that it's uncovered. I'm just saying. Love covers. Love says, I did it wrong that time, but I'm going to give you grace and help you do it right this time. Not just talk about me, but help me to get it right this time. You're not going to trust me to my own devices, but you're going to help me and hold me accountable for being a better me. Hold me accountable for being the loving me, the joyous me, the forgiving me. I mean, I just want to be more like God. And I can't be that without y'all. We got to be that together. We got to be that together. I'm only one piece to the puzzle. I need y'all to link up. Link up with the piece next to you. You know, not that sneaky link. I need you to link up. That real link. We good at the sneaky link. We real good at that. But I need you to link up for greatness. Can you link up for greatness? That's going to be my motto this year. I'm ready to link up for greatness. Can we link? Can we link? Can we link? Can we link? I'm going to link up for greatness. You know, sometimes linking up means we got to follow Angel, not me. I'm just saying. Because we linking up. And I may not know that way, but Angel know how to get there, so I'm gonna link up with her. Or this week it might be Connor, and I need to link up with her because I need to follow Connor because we made a right turn, and I ain't never been down this street before. We gonna link up. I'm just saying. Sometimes I follow David, and I don't know why sometimes he follow me, but okay. But we gonna link up. He knows, so we gonna link up. I'm glad you know. I'm gonna keep praying. We gonna link up.
Listen, I can run now.
I can run now because you gave me the energy to link up. I'm just saying, I was tired that day. But linking to you gave me what I needed. So now I can run on another day, right? Okay. Because we linked up. What? It's silent strength. You know what I'm saying? I called you on yesterday just to say, can we link up? For greatness, though. I don't want to link up for nothing else. I don't want to link up with nothing else. I want to link up so the person on the outside of this church can say, what can I do to be saved? Right. That kind of link up.
That's right.
All right, where am I? All right, now we're going to collect some money. We're going to have offering time. You know, so we can continue to sit in this building. and leak up.
Exactly.
Okay? We have the Tithely app if you want to give. Pastor has asked us all, even if we're giving online, to tap the plate so we can all be in one accord. One accord. We got that because we're linking up. All right, give as God has given you. And I'm going to go over here and get some of what Gigi got. I'm going to link up with her over here because it looks like she's getting something.
December 1st.
Thank you, Lord.
I know. And we did something new this year. We just put balls with ideas, suggestions on the tree. So if you can pull off a ball, take it with you, and there's a little book at the bottom of the tree. If you could sign your name and what you selected. We ask that you purchase something new for the family, not anything that you already have. If you have any questions or concerns about that, please share with me. We've asked for the holiday, for the parent or the mother of the child to get, or the family to get cash cards so that she can use it to the thing that she's trying to raise money for. So if you can give her as much as you can, I don't think there's a minimum, but if you can give her as much as you can when we say cash card. For those of you who are having trouble trying to find a cash card, I understand that AAA has cards that you, without a fee, that you can get if you're a AAA member. So most of people are AAA members, but if you're having trouble trying to get a card. As far as the books, most of us that I spoke to, but just want to make clear, when we said a toddler or a two-year-old book, we're talking about like an action book, a book where you like learn and you zipper up and you got a card and you read a story and it goes to that. So those are the things we're trying to encourage you to get, just a highly suggested item. And then for the clothes, 24 months is a good size. And then for toys, that age range. So I think it's fairly easy, but if you do have questions or concerns, feel free to talk to me about it. I had some good questions this week that really helped kind of clarify why I'm up here saying these things. Amen?
Amen.
So on December 16th, we'd like to invite you all here for our annual church celebration and fellowship. we have games, bring your games, or come and play with our games. We have food or hors d'oeuvres at that time, and it's at 7 p.m. And it's here at the church. So please come, bring a friend if you choose, if you trust us or want to be. Won't be embarrassed. We'll try not to play taboo, which most of the time does turn out wrong. But we'll be here on Saturday celebrating with you guys. Amen?
Amen.
All right. So then we get to December 31st. Just a reminder that that's our annual watch night service. But as you know, watch night service is 10 p.m. to the morning. And since that is a Sunday, we will be having morning service. So
yes.
We'll be asking or hope that you can join us for both morning and evening or late night. We don't have purposeful praise to tie you in by bringing you dinner. But if you want to come over my house, for some of you, you can come until that time. Some of you, you know who we are.
Oh my God.
And then January 14th, we move into the new year, 2024, which is a special, specialty year for us, for me. January 24th will be our biannual church meeting right after service. So please join us. And then February, we will be celebrating 16 years here at the church. We have a speaker already aligned, and I got an email that requests that I ask permission, but I didn't know what that meant, so I can't continue. I don't know about that, but we're working on it. I tried it, it didn't work. But we have a speaker, February 11th is our 16th church anniversary, and also close to that will be Luxie's birthday. I just started the church. Luxie was born shortly after that, so 16 years of Luxie. So govern yourself accordingly, and like I said, any questions or concerns, please see me.
Praise the Lord. I just wanted to greet everybody. Hey Mar, how you doing? Amen. Can we say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
You can say, you can do better than that. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Everybody, let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, let's bless the Lord, everybody. Hallelujah. Listen, the evangelist almost had me running. Amen. We give you glory and we bless your name. Amen. This is the Lord's doing. Amen. And it's marvelous in our eyes. Amen. Tell your neighbor, I'm linking up with you for success. Listen, I like what the evangelist said. That means I know that I can't do it on my own. Oh, God Almighty. Listen, y'all not hearing what I'm saying. I can't do it. I've been trying to do it on my own. But I'm going to help somebody. I've been trying to do it on my own. Bless your name, Jesus. I've been trying. See, some of y'all don't want to own the fact that you've been trying on your own. Hallelujah. Amen. But we're going, and there are some people you linked up with you had no business linking up with, because it wasn't for success. Amen. But a threefold cord cannot easily be broken. Amen. And so I'm going to link up. Amen. I wanted to run around the church, but she said, I'm going to link up. Amen. For you. Don't you just suit your I'm going to link up. First, I'm going to link up with Jesus. Then I'm going to link up with you. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to link up with the God in you. So that we all can be successful next year. Amen. And so we bless the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. I just felt Jesus. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Y'all playing with God. Come on, say hallelujah. Come on, say glory. Hallelujah. Come on, clap your hands and give God glory. Come on, clap those hands and give God glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Soul to praise him. That was the other thing that she said, my soul. But sometimes my mind is not in the right attitude. So, listen, y'all don't want to own that. Sometimes my mind is not in the right attitude, son. Oh, but out of the depths of my soul I cry, Jesus, draw nigh. Good God Almighty, if you can't link up with God with your mind, link up with your soul. Oh my, I command my soul to praise you. Yeah. I bring this sacrifice of praise. Because I link my soul wants to praise. My soul, all right. That's not what I wanted to do today. But I bring my soul. All right, I'm not the preacher. Amen. Pastor, we are planning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, my soul. And then when I get my soul together, then my feet get happy. Some of y'all don't understand that. My feet get happy when my soul gets happy. Hallelujah. And I'm going to help some of y'all. Sometimes you just got to praise them when you don't feel it. I'm just going to help you. When you don't feel it, Connor. Amen. You got to trick the enemy and you got to trick yourself and open up your mouth and give God glory. And just, come on, evangelist. Just start saying, God, I thank you. Lord, I bless you. Lord, I give you the glory. Amen. My bishop used to say, let them start out in the flesh, you enter out in the spirit.
Come on.
Amen. Anybody just don't feel it today? Amen. You're just not there today? Amen. I declare and I decree, if you open your mouth and bless the Lord and give God glory and tell God, thank you. It'll take you in. I want you to know. And guess what? It'll give you the strength for the next mile of the journey. Anybody just don't feel like it? Just say, hallelujah, Lord, I thank you. Oh, God, I bless your name. God, I give you the glory. God, I give you the honor. God, you're worthy of the glory. You're worthy of my praise. Because sometimes we just don't feel like it. All right. Amen. So I'm not going to keep going because I'm not the preacher. But I got a feeling everything going to be all right. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying. I keep that even in the darkest days, Elder. I got a feeling. I got a feeling. Because down in my soul, listen, the Holy Ghost is my witness that everything. The Holy Ghost, don't do it. She know old school. The Holy Ghost told me, amen, everything going to be all right. Then we used to say, be all right. Be all right. Be all right. It may not be all right, but by the time I get out of here today, it's going to be all right. And if my circumstance don't change, I'm going to be all right. So just one more announcement. I'm out of the way. Amen. We're going to Maplewood. Oh, my. I got a few. Hallelujah. The enemy told me it wasn't going to be all right. But, down in my spirit, there's a witness. Everything. Y'all hear what I hear? In my spirit. In my soul, there's a witness. The soul that he breathed into and gave life to that's always connected to God, my soul. All right. So, we're going to Maplewood. Everybody has their assignment. If you don't have an assignment for Maplewood, then your assignment is to be present. Amen. Rehearsal is Wednesday at 7 for the carolers. Amen. And so we bless the Lord. Amen. This is part of our outreach work. Amen. Amen. And how many of you know that somebody outreached to you so that you can hear the glorious gospel of Jesus Christ? And so we bless the Lord. Amen. We're working on some agenda things and some development things. The preachers and elders and pastors have a project you'll hear about in the first quarter. Amen. That will be for all of the saints to attend. Amen. And then in the beginning of the year, everybody say the beginning of the year. Amen. Pastor Quadre Blake Smith. Amen. Would like to come. He has consented to come and do the visioning party again. Amen. And so we need to not bring him from Pittsburgh for two people. Amen. I don't need to bring him from Pittsburgh for two. Amen. And so if you are interested, amen, he is excited about coming back home. Amen. And sharing and following up with those of you that have done the process and those of you that want to know what the process is. Tell your neighbor, if you don't have a vision, you'll perish. Oh, listen, amen. I'm going to help some of y'all. Some of y'all doing busy work, but not vision work. Amen. Call the pack. You're going to call me next week for that one. Some of y'all doing busy work. That's why you're not going nowhere, and that's why you're frustrated. Amen. Because without a vision, the people will perish. Amen. And some of y'all are perishing and burning out because you don't have a vision for your life. Amen. Vision leads to purpose. Amen. And when we have lost our purpose, we just wander aimlessly. But I know what anybody here know what your purpose is. So you're not doing busy work. Amen. And so he's willing to come. Amen. He's willing to share. And it's a workshop. How many of you attended the workshop last year? Amen. So he's coming back. Amen. It will be here. Amen. And so we will make sure that all the materials, all the food, there is food involved, I believe.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And so me and the pastoral assistant will work that out. But we need you all to let us know, amen, in advance before we book him. And he gives us a date and time because he's coming all the way from Chili, Pittsburgh. Amen. To be. Me and Alberta used to go to school there. Amen. From Pittsburgh to come with us. So please, ma'am, please, sir, please, they. Amen. However you identify. Amen. Please reach out to Jennifer. Raise your hand. Minister Jennifer. She will be able to take your name and your information for that. Is that all right?
Amen.
All right. It's time for the word. Amen. Is that right? Yeah, it's time for the word. Amen. How many of you are excited for the word today?
Yes. I see the curtain. I'm excited.
Some of y'all seem a little lethargic. Amen. How many of you are excited for the word of God? I'm a little bit better. God bless you, son. Amen. Can you? Yes, I just want to touch. Come here for a second. I just want to touch and agree with you. Amen. I just want to shake your hand and touch and agree. God bless you. Amen. It shall be well. And everything you ask for, God will bring it to pass. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. That next move that you're looking for in God. Amen. We touch and agree. How many of you want to touch and agree?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Striving is not in vain. Hallelujah. Come on, saints. Come on, saints. Hallelujah. It will be. Tell them it will be. No, y'all not saying it like anybody been in the place of I need something next from God. Amen. Come on.
It will be.
Even as God said. Not as you said, but even as God said. Amen. Amen. And so we touch and agree with heaven. Oh, my. And we touch and agree with you. Amen. That next year will not be a year that you have never seen before. And every door that you need to be open will be open. And every door, this is an important part, every door that needs to be closed will be closed. Ah, yes, Lord. Come on, somebody say in Jesus' name. Come on, say in Jesus' name. Say we declare it in Jesus' name. And it shall be so. And then I have to do that. You can praise him as you go. Let him, he's going to praise God as they go. Come on, praise the Lord with me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, praise the Lord with me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. All right. I did that, bro.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And so we bless the Lord. Amen. I was in prayer, and Mother Lena is dangerous to be. I have a prayer buddy like Mother Lena in prayer. Amen. So I was going through some things last week, and Mother Lena said, you have one job.
Why?
That's to be the deliverer.
Why?
Hallelujah. She said, you got one job. Amen. And that's to be the deliverer. Amen. Brian, can you come? Can I see you for a second? We're going to get to the word. You all right, Pastor Dana?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Elder Madison. Amen. Brother David. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Elder Jerome. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I know why. You'll hear why I called in a second. Amen. So I need David behind and the Elder Jerome. These are three elders. Amen. I wanted to touch and agree with you. Amen. These men are fathers. Amen. And there's nothing like the strength of other fathers. Amen. Encouraging other fathers. Amen. I wanted these men. Amen. And we're going to pray. Holy Ghost, I thank you. Hallelujah. Y'all don't mess with this. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I hear that God has not forgotten you. Hallelujah. God sees you. God sees what you're trying to do. God sees the struggles that you're trying to, that you're going through and what you're trying to do through your struggles. Amen. And we pray today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I need all y'all out there that's not watching. I need you praying. We pray today in Jesus' name, amen, that God strengthen you. Hallelujah, that God give you real direction. Ah, yes, Lord, and the only voice, that you will hear is the voice of God. The voice of God that strengthens, the voice of God that affirms. Hallelujah, the voice of God that strengthens your hand as a father. Oh, God, we pray the strength of Almighty God. Somebody say strength today. We come against the enemy. Oh my, we come against the enemy that would bring division, amen, in your life, division in your home. Hallelujah. We pray that God would be strength to you today. Amen. And in this coming year, that God would give you everything that you need. Well, somebody say everything. Y'all not saying it like it mean it. Somebody say, God, give them everything. Oh my, oh my. Oh my, oh my. That God give you everything, everybody. Everybody say everything. Oh my, that God open the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you will not have room to receive. In the name of Jesus. Oh my, yes, Lord, I hear you, Jesus. Hallelujah. God said, don't pray for money, but pray for wisdom. That God give you wisdom. Oh my, wisdom to speak to your family, wisdom to speak in your home, wisdom to speak in your job. We pray for wisdom in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We give God the glory. Come on, everybody, give God glory. Hallelujah. Come on, clap your hand, everybody. Give God hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. We come against the work of the enemy. Somebody say, the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. We come against the power of the enemy. Come on, say, Jesus, have your way today. Jesus, have your way. Hallelujah. I just heard God say, I've commanded a blessing. And I will not take it. I've commanded a blessing. Hallelujah. But God said, you got to look for the, seek ye the Lord while he may be found. The blessing is there. God give you the wisdom to find the blessing. God bless you, sir. All right, I'm sorry. I got to get ready to go. Amen. So we bless the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, fathers. Amen. Amen. I don't want there to be confusion why pastor didn't call on me. Amen. But how many know fathers have the strength for other fathers? Y'all don't play with me. They got the strength for other fathers. Only fathers know what other fathers go through. Only fathers know the attack that's on other fathers. Amen. And the stress that's on other fathers. Amen. And I praise the Lord for these men of God that are here. Amen. That are fathers. We're not perfect, but we're fathers. Amen. Amen. I'm not perfect. We're going to say some things and we're going to have a little testosterone moment. Amen. But fathers, tell them we love our children. Amen. And we would die for our children. Just don't play. Amen. As the pastor of this church, I would die for anybody in this church because that's my assignment. Amen. To be the deliverer. All right. It's time for the word of God and we can get there. Amen. Amen. Could you hold my Jesus? Come thou almighty King. Help us thy praise to see. Hallelujah. Oh God victorious. Reign up all over us. Ancient of days. Hallelujah. 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 Somebody just say hallelujah. Hallelujah. I need to teach y'all how to enter into the presence of God. Hallelujah. 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 Come on. Y'all need to learn how to enter into the presence of God. Hallelujah. Without all the fanfare, just enter. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Into the presence of God. Hallelujah. Oh my. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So rise to your rest and be blessed. Oh, the glory of your presence. Oh, your people, we give you reverence. So arise to your rest and be blessed by our praise as we glory. Wrap your arms around yourself and say, as I glory in the embrace of God. Ah, as I glory in the embrace of God. As I glory in the embrace of God. As your glory now fills this place. We're going to receive Pastor Dana. Amen. She's ready. Oh, God, but saints, I still have a feeling everything won't be all right. Amen. Tell your neighbor the devil gets nothing. Y'all not saying the devil gets nothing. If you book the devil got something, the devil gets nothing. Amen. Listen, I'm going to say that again. The devil got nothing. Change your perspective. Because there shall be glory after this. Oh, good God Almighty. Tell your neighbor, there shall be glory. No. Don't go slow on this. Tell your neighbor, there shall be glory. Tell your neighbor, there shall be glory after this. Good God Almighty. You thought this year was a bad year, but there shall be glory. Don't do it, Deacon. There shall be glory. Good God Almighty, after this, there shall be glory. Woo! Pastor Dana, you better come and get this mic, but I feel there shall be glory. Hallelujah, there shall be victory after this. Good God Almighty, there shall be joy after this. There shall be power after this. There shall be health after this. There shall be glory. Yes. Come on, Pastor Dana. Preach, but I feel glory after this. It was a hard year, Pastor Dana, but there's glory after this. Let's get out of here. There's glory after this. 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 There's glory after this and said I wasn't gonna make it, but I'm looking for glory. After this, your this is not greater than the glory that shall be revealed. After your this, the glory is gonna be greater than the this that you went through, the this that you struggled over, the this that you cried about. The glory shall be greater. Can y'all just receive Pastor Dana? Clap your hands and receive Pastor Dana. Come on, receive Pastor Dana. There shall be glory, saints.
Hallelujah. There shall be glory after this. He could have preached. Listen, that was a word in itself. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Father, we honor you. My God, Jesus. Do you know what your this is?
Whoa.
Lord, have mercy. Do you know what your this is? She said you just got here. But do you know what your this is?
Wow.
Pastor, I've been struggling with my this, but there shall be glory. And his mercy. And I want you to really hold on to there will be glory after this. There will be glory after this. So as I was, it was about maybe 2 weeks ago, I was driving in my car and I said, Father, I said, I just need you to speak to me about what's next. Speak to me about what it is that you are doing in this season of my life. And you know, I don't always like. I don't always like what he does. I don't, and I'm just gonna be honest with Pastor Dana and all that title. Dana does not always like what he does. I don't. Sometimes I'm like, God, but that's not fair. Why do I have to? Because I called you, I chose you, and you're going places that others are not going. And so I got to process you, my God, Jesus. Sometimes I got to process you in front of people.
Right.
Wow.
So you can get victory over people.
So I can get victory over people.
Right.
And it's not always easy. It's not always easy. Never. And so I said to the Lord, I said, God, you know, can I have those days when I'm behind the veil? Because so y'all already know that in the outer court, this is where the flesh is on parade. I do have notes and I do have scriptures, but I'm going to talk right about now. Amen. On the outer, y'all can hear me, right?
On the outer, this is where flesh is on parade. This is where you do what you want, you say what you want, you act how you want. You don't care about anything but what you want. This is where all of this happens. Mm-hmm. But the challenge for me is, Lord, Sunday school was amazing.
Yeah.
Without Sunday school books, Lord Jesus, I'm sorry, Lord. Jesus, I just got the look. Father, just charge it to my head, not to my heart. But we had an amazing Sunday school lesson where we were just talking about our next and what God is doing and how the Father is pulling some stuff out of us.
Yeah.
But here's the thing, right? Until you get the pulling out of you, you'll never get behind.
That's right.
Because you cannot be in the most holy of holiest places.
That's good.
And your flesh does what it wants. It just doesn't happen that way. So here is where the Father says, let me kill the flesh.
My God.
That's right.
Right here. Sometimes it's our mental.
Come on.
Right. I'm gonna let that sink in. Because maybe that may not be y'all, but maybe that's just me. Because my mind. Maybe, let me just tell you about this here mind. This here mind, it messes me up all the time. I be all thinking things and that ain't it.
Right.
I be worrying about things and that ain't it. I be trying to I create a whole scenario. But this is where I do that at. Because see, behind it, if you are in the presence of God, all of that stuff is killed. So which then says to me, and again, not y'all, but we know people, which then says to me, how often are we in his presence? How often are we going behind the veil? See, it's in that place. Thank you, Father. It's in that place that he speaks to me about me.
That's the hard part.
Some of us, it's not y'all, it's the people that we know. Some folks don't want to know about themselves.
Wow.
You can't get to glory because then you can't even be effective in the work that the Father has given to you unless you know about you.
Unless you know about you.
You got to know about you, your issues, your challenges, your proclivities.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that word used to crack me up on time. I said proclivities. All of that, unless you know about you. Because when you enter in, he going to strip you.
Yes.
Because now, thank you, Father, because now once you enter in, he says, now you are whom I need you to be. Because there's a work that has gone on.
Yes.
Behind the veil.
Right.
Wow.
Behind the veil. So okay, because you know I get excited and then don't read what I got. The veil has many meanings that are significant. One meaning pertains to, and I love this meaning. This was really good because when I got married, I don't even think I knew what the reason why. Everybody get married and you wear the veil. But I didn't understand the significance of it, right? So one meaning pertaining to a woman that is veiled is under the authority of a man. It also signifies, this is the part that got me, it signifies the perfect submission of the church to a loving rule of Christ. Loving. This is the part. Didn't you talk about love?
Yes.
Okay. Please preach about it.
Right.
Loving. In our church motto, love is building.
Yes.
If we don't listen, if we don't allow love to build, we miss the mark.
We do.
Because everything that the Father has done, it was in love. He sent his only begotten Son to die for you and I. That's love.
That is.
I wouldn't send my son to die for nobody. But therefore, I'm not Jesus. Amen. Amen. That was a sidebar. That was a sidebar. So, it is also this place of the being behind the veil or the veil. It is also a visual, thank you, Father, a visual sermon. It is a statement. It is a proclamation before the Lord that he is Lord.
Yes.
When we talk about going behind the veil, that means it's no longer my agenda, what I want, but it is all of you. You are Lord of my life. You can do what you want to do, how you want to do it. Out here, we compromise. We got our own plan. We do what we want. We say what we want, how we want to do and say. But when you enter in behind, no longer that. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Culturally, this is the this is the part that got me. So when we say and we hear people say, you know, I'm going behind the veil, or when people are talk about what's happening in their life, and child, I'm behind the veil today. This is where God is, and it's okay. And God bless your heart. But here's the thing: if there's no change when you come out, because culturally, we Lord Father, I don't. Yeah, amen. We say that in the church, and we do all of the necessary stuff, theatrics, thank you, on the outside, right? But there is no, there's no change. There's no change. We talk about it, but there's no change. Matter of fact, we testify about it, but there's no real change. Because when you go beyond the veil, when you come out, there ought to be a significant change that everybody sees and feels.
Right.
And as a, thank you, Father. And they hear it. Because now what you say is different.
Wow.
It's different. Very much so. But culturally, we talk about the change. But when we enter into a place where the Father wants to do a spiritual operation on us, we now dictate, well, I don't want that. No, no, but no, don't cut that away because I need that. That's kind of, you know, that is comfortable.
Oh my, there it is.
That's comfortable for me. And because it's comfortable for me, I need that. I need that. And God's saying, do you realize where I'm taking you? You can't have that. It's not going to go. It's not going to work. Lord, my son came in the book. It's not going to work. Thank you, Lord God. In Exodus, because I want to get here. Thank you, Father. In Exodus chapter 26, verse 33. Actually, the entire thing, but I'm not going to read the entire thing. But 33 is where I want to read. Is where I want to read. The veil also, the veil of the temple also symbolized the division, thank you, Father, between the holy place and the holy of holies, where the presence of God dwells. Another, thank you, Jesus, another symbolization or meaning or significance is seeing behind the veil, which refers to a gaining of insight or understanding behind the veil. Amen? So Exodus, Jesus. And I'm not going to be before y'all long, honestly. Exodus. So, if you read Exodus 26 in its entirety, and I had a good time reading this, and I kept saying, Lord, this is a whole lot, Jesus, but you're going to have to break this down and make it significant to where we're going and what it is that you want to do in and through us. Amen.
Amen.
But verse 33 says, and you shall hang the veil clasp. Then you shall bring the ark of the testimony in there, behind the veil. The veil shall be a divider of you between the holy place and the most holy. You shall put the mercy seat.
Well, you got it behind you. You got to get there.
Can I tell y'all something? Let me just tell y'all, because I got to be real transparent. When the Lord was giving me this illustration, I kept saying, Father, you got to do something, because I see what you're saying, but sometimes I don't, what you've given me to talk about, I'm like, well, how does, can you make it make sense? And then he told me this morning, he said, tell Sir Jazz and Shanika to get a chair. I passed it. I read the words, but I'm saying, what? Get a chair and put it behind. I said, okay. So, thank you, Father. You shall set a table. Uh-huh. My God, Jesus. You shall set a table outside of the veil and a lampstand across from the table on the inside of the tabernacle toward the south, and you shall put the table on the north. When I was reading this, I said, Father, you are so strategic about how you want things done. Listen, it's not just in the Word of God. It's in our lives. Have you ever been in a place where he, now maybe not y'all, but maybe it's just me, where he is taking you somewhere and he tells you, this is what I need you to put on. I need you to put this on for when you go there. As a matter of fact, when you go there, this is what I need you to do.
Right.
This is where I need you to sit.
Right.
When we are in the presence of an Almighty God and he speaks to us, he gives us strategic methods on how he wants things done. Not just in your life, but where he's taking you. If I don't listen to him as it pertains to what he is doing, when I go to where he's taking me, I will miss. I'll miss. To go behind the veil means to go, my God, Jesus, means to go beyond the regular religious, scripted worship.
Yes.
I probably shouldn't have wore red lipstick with that. It's to go beyond that. We, Lord, have mercy, God. Father, I thank you. We come to church. And there, for some, there is an expectation. And we talked about this in Sunday school. There is an expectation of what God is going to give to me.
Come on, sis. Right.
What God is going to give to me, but what have you given to the Father out here to get over there? What have you done for him lately? What have you sacrificed, my God, Jesus, for him lately? What has he spoken to you? And I know, listen, I know God speaks to all of us. What have you done on this side that is readying you for that side? Because let me tell you something, when you go beyond the veil, there is a place, my God Jesus, after this, where he then begins to, when he lifts the veil, and then he presents, my God, are you ready to be presented? Or are you still on this side doing your own thing, saying what you want? My Lord, chasing your tail. We know what that looks like.
Yeah.
One of the other things about going beyond the veil is the altar. The altar reflects God's standard. The desire, my God Jesus, his desire and ours for approaching a Savior that wants to give you what you need when you're in the place with him, when you're in this place behind the veil. Thank you, Father, there are things that the Father, in church, there's a standard. You know, when we come in, there's a standard, right? And as believers, we ought to follow the standard.
Right.
It is not, thank you, Lucy. It is not the pastor's standard. I'm going to say it one more time. It is not the pastor's standard. In other words, pastor, and maybe he did, but ultimately I believe that it's God. He doesn't come in and give you a bunch of rules and regulations that you have to follow and say this is the standard. No, what he does and what he has done is says this is, I know some of y'all got y'all Bibles on your phone, but this is the standard.
The whole Bible. That's the map. Come on.
This is the standard. Not part of it. Not the parts that you want.
Wow.
That's right.
Eat
the whole
school.
Right. The whole school.
Because we. Not y'all, but you know. We are constantly. Father, I thank you. And Lord, then I'm going to sit down. We are constantly. And let me tell you how people know. They know by the fruit.
That's right.
That you bear or that you don't bear.
That is right.
So we are constantly not living by the standard, and it shows in our attitude.
Yes, that's right.
It shows in how we walk.
Right.
It shows in what we say.
Ouch.
It shows. We talked about love earlier. You, listen, if you're going to love,
listen.
Please love unconditionally. Because
right.
We place too many conditions.
Woo.
We do. If you don't do this like I want you to do this, then I don't love you.
Wow.
It's true.
And we show it.
We show it.
We show it in how we, my God, we show it in how we respond when I see you next week.
Right.
Are you going to still kiss me and love me?
I'm going to do it to me.
He said, I'm going to do it. Yes, I know you do. Are you going to come up and hug me? Because let me tell you something. When you get beyond the veil, all that stuff is about to die. I asked the Lord. I said, God, I really, today, I don't want to scream and yell because I do that all the time. But I really want to talk, and I really want people to get the illustration. Because let me tell you something. The Lord said to me through my son, Jesus, y'all pray for me. Pray for me, because this boy, this man is talking some stuff, and it literally is making me get on my face even the more. Now, I'm praying already at 3 o'clock, Lord. But even the more, he said to me, and I likened it to this. He said to me, he said, Mom, he said, the Lord said to me, and this was him going into 2024. He said, the first 8 days, he said, God is going to be working with him and doing some things. He said, the first 4, God is going to be working on his strengths. He's strengthening him even the more. Thank you, Father. He said, but the next 4, he said, he's going to be working on my weaknesses. I said, what? Because a lot of times we don't want God, Lord, my weaknesses. No, this, leave alone, because this is my comfortable place. This is my place of comfort. This is nice. It's nice. It's my go-to. This is a Pastor Mike moment. It's my go-to. And so because it's my go-to, don't mess with that. Listen,
I won't have nowhere to go.
My God.
I won't have a comfortable place that when I feel like I, here we go.
Oh, Jesus, hallelujah.
When I feel like I don't want to do right, I want to have an attitude, when I feel like I don't want to talk to you, this is my go-to.
Oh my.
So don't take away my go-to. Matter of fact, can I be in 2 places?
Wow.
Stand in the middle.
Well, can't do it.
That's not how it works.
That's what we want. You leaving everything open.
The veil ain't shut. Everything is open. Guess what? So it is in your spirit, in your soul. My God, Jesus, when you don't submit yourself wholly. wonder why, not you, but we know people, you wonder why the enemy comes in and attacks you, how he does. Thoughts, your behaviors, because you trying to straddle the fence. You're trying to be in two places at once, you can't. This ain't Star Trek. So, on this side, the Father is saying, can I ready you for what's next? I asked a question in Sunday school. What does next look like for you? Anybody, what's next look like for you? Anybody? Just spit it out.
Oh, advances to the next level of education?
Okay. Come on.
Anybody else? What does next look like for you? This interactive church today.
Me finding out who I really am.
Finding out who you really... Woo! Baby! You ready? Maybe you ought to come up here. Woo, God! That is a big one. That is a big one. Anybody else? Come on.
Strategic moves.
Strategic moves. Are you ready?
Yep. Accepting who we are.
Accepting, are y'all listening to these things? Accepting who you are. Because can I tell you something? Out here is not really who you are. Because we haven't allowed God to do some cutting on us.
Right.
I'm not going to take your clothes off. I didn't mean it like that. That's why I said I was going to dress you, because I was going to put something else on so I could take your clothes off. But it's okay. So I'm just.
You get it.
Y'all get it. Yeah. So I'm taking. Illustration, I'm taking off a layer that the Father doesn't want of the flesh.
That's right.
He doesn't want certain things behind the veil. So what he does is he speaks to you to tell you, surrender yourself to me. Submit to me now. Because when we go behind, there is going to be a change and a transformation that takes place. The reason why, and again, please read Exodus 26. He was very, very specific about this place. He was very specific. And he is so very specific about you and what he wants out of your life when the veil is lifted. That's why things always on social media.
Wow. Come on, to say that one.
Everything. Your whole life. Everything you do and say is on social media. And God is saying, there are some. This is why, thank you, Father. This is why the enemy can pinpoint areas in your life to attack. Because you put everything on social media, you show your whole hand. Has there ever been a time in your life, Father, I thank you. Has there ever been a time in your life where he's told you, shh, don't share that.
Yeah.
Be quiet.
Yeah.
Because what we do is we tell the enemy how to get to us.
Wow.
That's what we do.
And
God is saying, in this next season of your life, shh. So, as we are, or when we enter in behind the veil, there is a work, thank you, Father, that is taking place within us. For some, God literally is gouging out of your heart those places, my God, Jesus, that have been dwarfed in your life, the hurt, the pain. I know from pastor to the youngest child in here, I know that there's been some places in our lives that have scarred us. And we think that when I'm done. I so love how the Holy Spirit works. Do y'all hear her? It has scarred us. And we think that we're going to do all of what he wants us to do with this scar. And he's saying, wait a minute. I don't know if y'all seen this stuff that if you put this balm or this cream on it, it clears up the scar. God says, can I be the balm that clears the scar? Can I be the one that literally, when I present you before a people with what I have done in you behind the veil, when I present you, that they can see me? Do you honestly think that he wants you to go through all the things that you go through for nothing? No. His desire is to present you so that you can be Jesus, little J, in the earth realm. So you are representing him well. But sometimes I gotta cut away from you. I gotta do a work in you that we may not like. I started out saying, there are some things I just don't. God, I don't want to. I don't always want to be the one. Here we go. I don't always want to be the one that's always forgiving when I didn't do nothing.
Right.
Right.
Come on.
I didn't do nothing. I don't always want to be the one to go and say, I apologize. I didn't do nothing. Now, that ain't y'all. Because me and Jesus, we have the whole conversation. It wasn't me. Why do I have to? Why do I have to go? Why do I have to extend an olive branch when it wasn't me? I didn't do nothing. But it gets you behind the veil. And if you really want to be all that God wants you to be, baby, you will go and say, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. When you ain't do nothing, but you'll do it anyway.
Woo. Yes, you will.
Your flesh will die, my God Jesus. The book is coming. The book is coming. The book is coming. The flesh dies on this side, not over there. So you gotta allow your flesh to be killed on this side. The reason why some of us are stuck is because we won't allow the flesh to die.
Woo!
Wow.
Come on.
Yes.
Yes. We're stuck. Because we won't allow the flesh to die. Because we're too prideful.
Right.
Wow.
Right.
It's a but sin. It's that is
it
a
is.
Sin.
It is.
I come to put it on.
Yeah.
We too prideful. I'll leave it there.
Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank
it
you,
does.
Lord. Thank you, Lord.
And we, we want to be able to move forward. And God is saying, until your flesh, all of it.
Not the parts you want to.
Exactly. Not the parts. Right. All of it. Until it dies on this side. You can't get to this that side. And then the work that he wants to do that will be done on this side. I cannot now present you and give you and you reach destiny because you won't allow the work to be done on this side. And that's the other part. It's your work.
Oh, right.
Yes, it is.
It's your work. It's your work. We were talking in Sunday school about doing our work. No, it's not always easy, but it's worth it.
So worth it.
Sometimes, Pastor said it earlier, sometimes you need people to help you
right. In
your work. I shared a testimony. I was at an event yesterday that was absolutely amazing. And it is for my next. And I said to the Lord, I said, you know, everybody knows me as Pastor Dana, the preacher. But everybody doesn't know that I have a mentor program. Everybody doesn't know that I own a title company. And I've called myself, actually other people have called me, you know, the real estate, they've called me Dr. Divine, which is crazy. The real estate resource consultant. Because everybody that I meet, when they tell me, I heard that. Can you? Yes. Let me connect you. Let me connect you. Let me connect you. Wow. Let me connect you with these folks. Let me link you to somebody that can help you. But they don't know that side of me. They only know the preacher side of me. And God says, in order for you to go where I want you to go, your flesh, your fear. Your fear of failure. Yeah. Your fear of not being enough.
Wow.
Maybe that ain't y'all. Oh my God. But let me just be very transparent. It is so mean sometimes.
Right.
Yes, it is.
Your fear of not being enough.
Yes.
I don't have enough, God. I don't have what it takes. I sat at the table with Marek Brown Clark and doctors. Me! And I sat there and David, I can talk to y'all.
You can talk to me.
But I sat there. I opened my mouth. I didn't, do you hear me? I didn't open my mouth. I sat there. I smiled. Because I was looking real cute. I was cute. Face was beat to the knife.
I know that's right.
Baby, I was cute. But I sat there. And then, thank you, Father, on this side. Oh! On this side, he will reveal to you your challenges and your issues, things that you cover up. I said, I am, hi, my daughter just walked in. I am not as social as I go. I might be a little introvert. Didn't even realize. And I'm saying to myself, Lord, how am I going to get to the masses? These places that you've called me to, I already know. You said it to me. How am I going to get there? I can't even socialize among these jokers. I'm scared. And God said, for your next, see, sometimes there are places that are so uncomfortable because he is. He's pulling you out of places that you've sat in for years. I said, because you got comfortable. I said, people only know Pastor Dana. But that's not all. That's not all of who I am. Lord Jesus, I'm getting to that part. I'm trying to wait for the Lord to keep doing some stuff behind this here bed. Because I had to get behind there. I had to literally say to myself, while I was sitting at the table, Pastor, I had to say to myself, go and get yourself behind the veil. Because guess what? You're about to get the microphone. And they're going to require of you. Can you grab my phone? They're going to require of you some things. Now here comes the elevator speech. Who are you?
That's right. Right. That's what they taught us.
Who are you?
That's what they taught us.
Not what you wear.
That's right. Who are you?
Who are you? And I... My pocket... Oh, I'm sorry, baby. I'm so sorry. Y'all, I'm almost done, but I gotta share this with y'all. Who are you? And I said to myself, first of all, if they hadn't given me the microphone beforehand, I am Pastor Dana Divine, Slim Ministries, and I da 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 da. Really? That's who you are?
Yeah. That's what you do.
That's what I do.
Right. They took you there, didn't
they? Pastor, when I tell you this is the most scariest place that I've ever been in my life, and I keep saying to myself, you're going to make it.
You won't make it.
You are.
This is a different place. This is a different season. But you got what it takes. So, I'm going to tell y'all what I said, or part of what I said. But there was still some work going on. Wow. See, this is the work that sometimes don't nobody see. It really is. It's ongoing. Here's the thing. We had to die. The flesh had to die on the outside just to enter in. So when you entered in, it's no holds barred. So now he gonna do what is necessary. I'm going to share this and then we're going to finish. I got one, two more scriptures and we're done. Let me reintroduce myself. I never find it. Yes, and I actually look at my pocketbook and give me my other phone, please. Lord. You do? Because Courtney actually helped me.
Okay.
Yes.
Y'all linked up.
And we linked up for greatness. I had to introduce myself. So this is what I said. I didn't say it all because my hands were shaking. But this the gist of it. I am Dana Devine, a real estate consultant. I actually added resource. A real estate resource consultant, spiritual thought leader. I altered it. Can you grab my other phone? Thank you. Huh, you take that. I'm going somewhere, y'all. Give me one. No, this one. Thank you.
Three.
Give me 1 second. I got three phones, y'all. Don't judge me. Just pray for me. Yes, Lord. Here it is. I altered. I meant to send this to you, but that's fine. But you did this. Amen. I am Dana Devine, spiritual thought leader, real estate resource consultant, and mentor, committed to using my diverse skills to provide life services and solutions to the underdog. You know, those that everybody throws away. To the underdogs of the world. It is my life's assignment to help the underdog identify the lion within and champion life. Now let me just say this. I'm so glad y'all thought it was good. Maybe I got to the, I am Dana Devine, spiritual thought leader, in real estate. I gotta walk what I say. Yes, I'm about to get you the microphone. But all of that, because I killed my flesh and my fear, all of me now walking in, God was preparing me behind the veil to be.
So y'all know, I don't know about y'all, you know, but when I was in school, I was at performing arts school, right? And y'all know we was behind the veil and we was behind the curtain and we was getting ourselves ready to be presented. And when they opened up the curtain, you was ready in your stance or whatever.
Oh, all right. Know,
because you know I was a dancer and a singer. Right. And so I was ready. Right?
Right.
I was ready. I was in position to be presented to whom I was going to serve. So what happens is, when God does the work, oh my God! Woo! I'm sorry, y'all just got a glimpse. When he does the work, because the flesh was killed on this side, when he does the work, he then presents you. Now, this is the final call. Woo! Sorry, y'all. All right.
All right now, mama. All right now.
Come on, spotless.
And he does it. Not people. He does it. He then presents you.
He then presents you.
Come on.
All right, come on now.
To whom you are now going to minister to and be an example to. He presents you now to the people. Faultless.
Come on.
That's the wrong way. Yeah.
He presents you. The final call. My God, Jesus. Father, I thank you. Go to Luke. Do I want to do Luke 17 or do I want to do 1 John 3? Let me hold on. Thank you, Lord God. I said Luke 17, but I wanted to make sure that this is where I want to go first. 17. Hold on. Luke 17 and 30, it says, even so will it be in the day when the Son, stand up, Gigi. I'm sorry. Y'all take notes for her. When the Son of Man is revealed. Just turn around. Just face the people. When the Son of Man is revealed, it will be in the day, symbolized, it will be in the day that God will reveal you to whom he has called you to serve. He will reveal who you are. The Son of Man, my God, Jesus, 3 days. He was in the tomb. Y'all, please catch the revelation. He was in the tomb behind the veil. God was doing a work in him. Uh-huh. Listen, there were some folks that said, he did and he gone. But in 3 days, thank you, Father. For some, yes, Holy Ghost, I hear you. For some, God says, I will do in 3 days if you surrender and submit to me what wasn't done in 15 years. I'll do it in 3 days. I'll do it in 3 days. But there has to be, thank you, Father, a level of total obedience to my voice. You must surrender to me. Flesh got to die daily. Go to 1 John. I'm done. 1 John. You got 1 John 1, 1 John 3, I'm sorry, and 2. Can you read that for me? No.
Beloved, now we are children of God, and it has not yet been revealed what we shall be. But we know that when he is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him
as he is. Listen, but oh my God, behind the veil, you had a face-to-face encounter with the Savior. And when he presented you, you are like what he wants. You are the I-O. Come on, help me preach, girl. You are the I-O-G.
Right.
The image of God.
Right.
The final curtain. God's presence anointing his people to manifest his glory in the earth realm. That's the final curtain. So, I submit to you today. Please allow, thank you for your obedience to helping me illustrate. Please allow the Father. And so I'm walking in, thank you. I'm walking in this place of spiritual thought leader, right? That says, I charge you to think about what it is that you want in your life. How you gonna get there? And will you totally submit to the Father so that you can be what he wants? The influencer, my God Jesus, that I am, stands before you and say, listen, you don't have to do it alone. We can walk this thing out, but you will go to where God has called you. On my watch, I'm every step of the way.
Even when you feel weak, listen, when you feel weak, I was weak because I knew that he was going to give me the microphone and I had to say what I needed to say. And listen, there was nobody sitting at the table that I knew. But I had to call on a savior that said, listen, I'm going to get you behind the veil right now. So when you stand up, I'm about to present you. And because of my obedience, now I'm walking in a place that I am so unfamiliar with. But I'm so ready. So ready to be me, Dana Divine. Or just Dana. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So I thank and I praise God for what he is doing in your life. Please, ma'am, and please, sir, allow him, even now, to kill your flesh. Allow him to. It's all right. Because this is the thing. He going to kill what he don't want. He ain't killing you. It might hurt. But he ain't killing you. I said he ain't. It's not you. It's the things that he does not want. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Listen to this song.
Yet there is one thing my soul longs for, is to worship you.
Just about to say, if there's anyone that needs prayer, that wants to touch and agree, thank you, Lord. If there is one, 2, 3, 4, 5, if you would please come, just come to the altar. Elder Jerome, if you will come. Can you guys do me a favor? Can you just spread out right across? Can y'all come with me? And can y'all spread right across? Yeah. Well, I'm going to pray for you after this. Thank you, Lord God. Sometimes it takes people. See more in you than you see in yourself. I can say both of these people.